Okay, a stinky buddy update. He still stinks, doesn't he? I know. Mr. T's like over here like, dude, do something with that horse. All right, everybody's been saying putting baking soda on it, so I'm going to go get some baking soda, and I'm going to try that. So hang on, I'm going to go in the house and get some baking soda. Hang on, buddy. I'll grab you a carrot because I'm going to rub all that crap on your head.
Or stinky buddy.
Man, that damn horse stinks so bad. I can't believe you people in the UK don't have skunks there. That's like amazing. So let me I'm gonna have to get a halter while they hold his head. Baking soda on his forehead where it's at. Stop it. Stop it. There ain't no sense of that. You said. Oh! Oh, God. It's... Oh. Well, that sure didn't help dry, but hopefully, this baking soda will get rid of the oil. So running out here. You were like a wild man. So Mr. T found the, there's some bird food I had over there. So Mr. T found that. So I'm going to go get him. You can watch him eat. He'll probably leave. He might finish eating. I'm going to give him his little grain. I didn't give him his grain earlier. I gave him hay today. I'll get your grain, boy. Don't walk out of the camera. Dude!
rain out.
Buddy already had his carrots. All right, buddy, I'll go get yours.
Crazy mules. So buddy's waiting for his, like, dude, what's up with that? Buddy, you smell better? You smell better, or are you stinky like the skunk? I know you're stinky, okay. Let me go get your food.
Won't let the teeth eat you.
Walking over there to feed him, it stinks. Crazy horse. He'll be playing with a skunk tonight. So he's in there eating his little food. He's got to eat by himself because he stinks. Nobody wants to eat with him.
Rick, that's bullying. You shouldn't. He just stinks. We need to be inclusive and caring and we should be tolerant.
He freaking stinks. Take a shower if he wants me to be tolerant.
Crazy mule. All right, so Mr. T's eating. I'm gonna go put this baking soda in the bucket. Garage. So I think tonight's gonna be our first freeze. Dogs back there raising cane. Everybody keeps asking me what happened to the dogs. They don't come visit anymore, but you can hear them barking back there. There's Monkey Kit. You hear those dogs back there? So those are the dogs that used to come visit me. And they live at that house back there. You hear them screaming? I can't see them. Where they're at. They sound like they got something cornered back there. Well, somebody just shot something over there. Maybe it was that skunk that got Buddy. So I don't know where they're at. But the dogs that used to come visit me live back there. So it's not the house directly behind me. There's a house back here that's directly behind me, but they live next door. And when I ride my bike over there, I still see them. But I don't know what's going on now. They're not barking. So something. So the sun's kind of going down over there. You can see kind of reflection, but here's our sunset over here. We'll get to sunset with Mr. T eating.
There's old Mr. T eating with a sunset behind him. What are they shooting at over there, Mr. T?
I don't know what kind of cannon that is. I know the guy that has that, but man, when he shoots that sucker, it echoes. And today's Sunday. He usually shoots on Sunday. So, as long as I don't have whizzing by my ear, I don't care what he's shooting over there. I think he's just target practicing, but. So tonight's our first freeze. I got all my sockets, their water buckets plugged in, so their water won't freeze. Even though I think it's only gonna get down to like 30. But if it says 30, it usually is 29, 28. So, I mean, they might get a little ice over their other bucket, but I got the heater in the other one. And so we'll have good water. Usually the birds come in here and eat their food. If Mr. T hadn't eaten it, you can tell I throw down some bird food. But it looks like Mr. T was kind of cleaning it up for him. So, and I hear him starting to gather around at sunset. They're like, dude, why can't we eat our... There's a good little cardinal right there. Y'all see him? Let me see if I can zoom in on him. He's right. There he is. See him? He's like, dude, I wanted to eat that food. That's our little cardinals here. Somebody in UK said they were different. Anyway, I can't believe you guys in the UK don't have freaking skunks. Wow. You're asking what it smells like? Let me tell you, it freaking stinks. I wish next time I catch a skunk, if he squirts on a towel or something, and you put an address in the comment, I'll put that freaking towel in a jar and I'll mail that shit to you. And then you can see what it smells like. Because it freaking stinks. And when you open that jar, you'll be like, oh my God. And you'll be like, that's what Buddy smells like. Oh my God. I've got towels in the garage now from 6 months ago where a skunk hit it. And if it gets damp, you can still smell it. When I was in the military, one time I was running, I used to let my dog run. I was trying to teach him that when I hit my siren, he should return to the car. So I would start out to where I would drop him off. I'd tell him down, stay, and then I'd drive, you know, long enough to where he could still see me. And I don't know, maybe not quite as far as my driveway, but I would drive away and I'd yell out the window, stay, stay, and he'd be laying on the road waiting for me till he'd come. And then I would hit the siren and say, come on, buddy. And as soon as I hit the siren, he'd come running. So after a while, if I lost him, we were out there running, I'd hear a siren, he'd run to the siren, and that's what I wanted him to do. So at night, when I'd go back to the kennels to put him up, he's sitting in the car all night, we're driving around doing shit, and you know, neither one of us getting too much damn exercise. So I would drop him off about a mile or two from the kennel, and I would just drive. I should probably put this on my crazy dogs. Maybe I'll put this on my dog channel for a crazy dog story. So we're about a mile or two from where the kennel's at, and I'm driving there, and I'm going to drop him off. So at night, I'd be like, all right, we had a good time. Hop out. And he'd get used to it because he'd like to just run. And I would let him out, and I would just drive back to the kennel. And he would run as fast as he could. Sometimes he'd keep up with a car. Sometimes he'd pass the car. He'd shoot off in the woods and chase things. Then he'd come back on the road. And, you know, if I lost him, I would hit the siren. He'd come out. So we're driving back to kennel, and normally I can see him, and if he disappears, it's usually for a short time, and then he'd run back out. This was in Ohio when I was stationed in Ohio. So I'm getting, you know, we gone for a mile now, and I was keeping an eye on him. All of a sudden, he disappeared, and I went, damn, I can't see him. Normally he comes out by now, so I slowed down. He still didn't come out. So then I stopped, and I said, Herc, Herky. His name was Herc for Hercules. So I'd call him Herky sometime. I'd say, Herky! Herc! And he wouldn't come. And I'm like, what the hell? So I hit the siren. Whoop, whoop, whoop! I'm hitting a siren, he's not coming. All of a sudden I see him shoot out of the freaking bushes. And I'm like, boy, where you been? You better get your butt in his car, come on! Because I was ready to get off, and now I gotta stop and look for him. I go, get your butt in his car! So he jumps in a car, and he's all happy to see me like he normally is. And I jump in the car, I start driving. He's rubbing his head all over me. And I'm like, dude, why are you so lovey? I'm petting him. Were you a good boy? Or were you chasing him? And then all of a sudden, if you've never smelt a skunk when it's like fresh right on you, it smells like petroleum, like you got in gasoline and oil mixed. It's this petroleum really strong. It doesn't smell like a skunk.
And I was like, holy shit, what did you do? You went around rolling some diesel or some shit? What did you find? So I'm, and then it starts smoldering in the car. And I was like, damn, that kind of smells. Holy shit. Well, by this time, you know, we've already driven down the road and he's rubbed on every damn thing in the car. And I had a station wagon back then. So he had a whole backseat area. We'd lay the backseat down. He'd have the whole run of the back area. Man, that freaking car stunk for a month, 2 months. They wouldn't let me in the building. All my gear, my leather gear, my gun, when I turned my gun into the army, they're like, what the hell did you do to this gun? Like, oh, my dog got skunk, man. They're like, shit, he's stinking up the freaking... So they were cleaning the gun. All my leather gear just stunk like crazy. My jacket... And then... So like 2 weeks later, they finally, for a while, they're like, look, man, you can't come into the building with that dog. Everybody's complaining. Everybody has to stop work. Everybody's sticking their head out. What the hell is that smell? So we couldn't go in the building for like a week or two. So finally, we start going back in the building, and he's starting to lose his scent. And of course, I went and bought a whole bunch of, you know, tomato paste. I gave him a tomato bath, hosed him two or three times, shampoo. I was doing all this shit. Well, skunk, that smell, whenever it rains, it makes it pungent, and it comes back like you were just skunked again. So 2 weeks, we're getting good. We finally got access back to the building, and it's raining that day. I go in the building with that dog, and he freaking shakes. And when he does, he gets stinky water. Man, there was some people pissed off at me. God damn it, Gore, that damn dog, they stuck up the whole building. Oh, poor Herky. He was such a good dog. He was like, I'm just a good dog. I didn't know. I was just chasing a skunk. Gosh, dog, he stunk like a bandit. Woo. So anyway, all right, buddy just got finished eating. I was just telling a skunky story about a stupid dog I had. And he was kind of the same colors as you, buddy. He was that kind of blondish looking Herky dog. What are you doing, buddy boy? Is that baby powder kind of help your head? Are you not stinking so much? Poor buddy. Hey, stinky horsey. Hey, stinky horsey, buddy. Hey, stinky horsey, buddy. Ooh, Dad found a carrot. Look, Bud's got I got a little bit of carrot. Buddy, I found a carrot. You want it? He knows that sound. You want your carrot? Buddy, you want your carrot?
He's not talking to me.
Oh, quit being a big baby. I can't help it if you stink.
Want it?
Your nose isn't too bad. I can give you a kiss on your nose. It's not too bad. I know. Only when we get in that area. Woo! Crazy horse. Oh my God, my hand stinks. What do you keep looking over here for? There has to be some sort of animal or coyotes or something out there, because you are like really stuck on that pasture over there. How much does Mr. T have left to eat? He eats slower than you, and he gets more than you. Hey, he's not doing too bad. See, Mr. T, I give him like, he gets 3 cups of his senior bran, the little red cup I use, and 1 cup of rice bran. Buddy gets 1 cup of senior and 1 cup of rice bran. So Mr. T gets a little more. Buddy just gets kind of like a, I just trick him so he thinks he's getting the same. Rick, you're mean to him. I'm not mean to that damn horse. Look at that sunset. What are you looking at? I don't know what you're looking at. I know, you're a good boy. Buddy is a stinky horsey, stinky, stinky. Buddy is a stinky horsey, he's a stinky horsey. Oh, man. You're lucky I care about you, you little rascal. I'd be letting you loose. Go find you a new home. Rick, don't give him away. I'll take him. I can hear all these people now. I want him. Give him to me. Nobody wants him. They only want him because they see him on camera. Once you had him, you'd be like, yo, man, I got to give you this horse back. Don't try to be cute. You're trying to find a new home. Don't even try it. You're in big trouble. Oh, that sounded like a red tail caught something, huh? What is that squeaking? Sound like a red-tailed hawk grabbed something. I know I'm looking over there too, buddy. I don't know what the hell that is. See, he can see something I can't see. He's looking right out here. Maybe you guys can see something that I can't see. That's exactly where he's looking at. Birds are getting a little active. Mr. T should be about done. He's got his curious look. That's what he looked like right before the skunk hit him between the eyes. He's like, dude, why are you laughing at me? He called his agent. His agent called me. Said, hey, man, buddy's upset that you're telling everybody he stinks. Oh, my goodness. That was a loud one. That one made Mr. T flinch. He's like, damn it. I'm trying to eat. It's not Dad. His buddy's got something over there. Definitely something over there. Oh, Mr. T went to eat in the bird seed. Okay, it's time for his butt to go back out. Come on, Pontoon. You're going back to the You don't need to eat that bird seed. Why do you finish this up? Come on. Where'd that crazy mule at? See, buddy's drinking out of the, he's drinking out of the heated water because he's a big baby. Mr. T's drinking out of the cold, regular water. That's why I give him a choice. The one buddy's drinking out of has heat. They're like, what the hell is the hell shooting over there? There was one little piece of carrot I found in my thing. I put in a bucket before Mr. T could get in there to eat it. Buddy ate it. So he's drinking it out of a heated water bucket. You guys think I pick on him calling him a big pansy, but he is. I know he can't help it. It's okay. If horses had buses, Buddy would be in the short bus. Rick, you can't say that. All right, whatever. Lead Mr. T off to. Oh, I gave him some hay there earlier, so there's a little bit of hay on the ground that they probably missed. So anyway, I was saying I winterized, and I sprayed that the socket down where I plugged that water bucket in. There's a little plug right there. And I sprayed that down with that, if you watch my other channel, Good Luck America, I did a thing on using contact cleaner and contact conditioner. And I cleaned my fuses out, and I sprayed some of that in there. Man, now the plugs go in nice and easy. So I did that with the barn. Inside my water well there, I have a plug and I have a heater with a couple lights. And if it gets below 40, the lights come on. I've got a little thing in there that turns on the power at 40. So the heat strip comes on, so my water pump, its water won't freeze. And so I sprayed all those sockets down. They're all smooth now, too. So that's some good stuff. If you want to go to Good Luck America and look up CRC Contact Cleaner and Conditioner, I think, is in the title. And you should be able to find a video. It's a pretty cool little video. You spray it, and it cleans it, takes away corrosion, makes all your light sockets. You can spray it in light sockets that with the electricity on. And then your plugs go in and out easy. It stops any corrosion.
It makes you have better contacts. So, anyway. All right, sun's going down now. And temperature's dropping. I think it's like, I don't know, maybe 45 right now. And I think it's supposed to get down to 30, which probably means 28 or 29. So they got their little food. I think it's about maybe 5:30-ish, maybe 6. So because they just ate their grain, I'll come back out here about 10 tonight, and I'll give them some hay. And they'll have some hay to keep them warm through the night. And that's how we'll call it a night with the boys. Okay, follow up with poor Buddy getting skunked. Stinky. If you visit Buddy, always stay upwind unless you want to smell him. Well, in that there, Buddy 15, you're good boys. Where's that crazy cat? I don't know where Mokey Cat went. He must have left. Well, that was another funny story. Shit. This morning, I hear Mokey at the front door going, meow, and it wasn't his normal meow, meow. When he wants to come in, I hear his mouth open. He's like standing at the front door going, meow, 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 really loud. Well, this morning I heard him out there kind of scurrying, and he's like, and I was like, shit, I wonder if he's hurt. Well, I learned before, I don't open the door without looking first with him. Because last time I did that, probably 6-8 months, maybe a year ago, he had a freaking mouse in his mouth. And as soon as I opened the door, he dropped it, and it ran right in the house. And it took me an hour to catch. I was so mad. Oh my God, that mouse was running around the house. I was like, are you kidding me? And every time I'd catch him, all my furniture was turned upside down. Everything's in the middle of the floor. Every time I got close to him, he ran another area. I don't remember how. I think he ended up running in my boot, and I was able to grab my boot and trap him in there and get him out. But, I mean, that was like an hour of cussing and turning all my furniture, keeping my eye on him because I didn't want him to disappear and lose him. So, anyway, I learned to look out before I open it. Sure enough, I open the door. He's got this big old fat mouse, as big as his head, in his mouth, and he's got it shut, and he's going, with his mouth shut, because he can't open his mouth, because he's got that mouse. And when he sees me look out, I go, I ain't letting you in with that in your mouth. He drops it, and the thing goes running and scurrying off, and then I open the door, and he came in. I go, are you trying to get your ass beat, boy? You let that thing loose in my house, I would have beat both of you. But anyway, wind's picking up, and it's getting cool. Well, in that there,